So hello guys, welcome back to Gaming Mac Channel. In today's video, I want to discuss about the hurdle race problem in HackerRank. So firstly, by getting into the concept, I mean that there are two major operations included in this problem. There, first one is that of finding the highest height in the given height of array. So let's get into the question first, the hurdle race. We do actually play more video games like and compared to me, I will play games like Rainbow Six Siege, Watch Dogs Legion, and also Assassin's Creed Origins, etc. So this problem is basically video game players. I mean, a video game based on a video game. So in the video game, a character competes in a hurdle race. So in a hurdle race, there are varying heights. I mean, hurdle race. What is meant by hurdle race? Basically, hurdle race means it's like a jumping game, and also there are different kinds of heights in which the guy should reach, I mean the character, given character should reach that respective heights. So here there are given a different heights, I mean different leaps like this. There are different heights and the guy should jump here and also from here to here, here to here, here to here, etc. So he should take doses which are, doses means that kind of, you can think that energy unit. It's like an energy unit, I mean, so it should be having some potential now to take that heights. I mean, initially you should have some energy. So here the k value is shows that height of the character that can jump naturally. So it's the natural jump. Like if you see the Mario games, there's some spawns like that. So when he jumps on that, he will jump more, I mean twice of his height. I mean, actually initially he can jump up to some x. After jumping on that steep, I mean like that spawns like material, he can jump to 2x, I mean 2x times. Like that, int k is the natural jump here, like that of x. So, but he should jump a height of, height array like sum of 6, where 6 may be greater than or equal to x. I mean, so if the given height is higher than that of that x, he cannot jump, right? So in order to jump, he should take some, in this game, he's taking some sort of items like doses. He mentioned it as a dose, like eating some sort of, drinking some sort of Red Bull like that. Okay, so we should find out that how many units. Here, units are compared to the units of height. I mean, units of dose he takes is compared to units of height. So I'll take that as a, k is 4 units. Means, he can jump 4 units naturally. And he can jump 4 units naturally. So let's consider that basic concept. So here uses two major operations are included here. First, we have to find the maximum height, of the given array, So here different heights are given in respective fields. I mean 1, 6, 3, 5, 2. So here the maximum height is 6. We must find that 6 in the first operation. This is first operation, And the second operation is we have to give him the doses. Here, I already mentioned you that the doses units are mentioned the same, as same. So, like he's drinking some of 4. So, for each one dose of Red Bull, he will jump 1 unit. Like we consider like this. So, initially he can jump off 4 units. So, he has 4 units of energy. Still, how many units of energy is needed to jump the highest? Obviously, if he can jump the highest one, he can jump the remaining elements in that of height array, right? So we must find the height and we must minus that from the initial energy so that we will get the return value, I mean the output as how much energy he needed, right? So I will find that energy using this. So firstly, the second operation is the subtraction. Here, the second subtraction operation, which will find the amount of energy he needed. I mean, how much Red Bull cans he should drink like that. Okay, let's get into the logic, basic logic. Now you have got, I mean, we shall now see the pragmatic way. Now, up to now we have discussed the theoretical way, right? So now we will discuss the pragmatic, practical way. So getting into the coding, I mean, that logic part. I will take I is equal to 0 and j is equal to 0 and result is equal to 0, which is the return value as the function is of int type. I will output the result value. So for in this operation, I mean, this for loop is used to find the highest value. I mean, highest value in the respective array. So I will iterate I is equal to 0, I is less than count, I plus plus. If the height, this is the first index element is less than or equal to ith index means I will change that position into height. So I will get the first element, I mean the zeroth index element as the highest element, means it repeatedly swaps me. I mean, it finds the first highest element and repeatedly gets into swapped. And it's not a swapping, direct storing. It will directly store it into the first index. So here the array is changed, but we need the respective result value. So I will find it. Okay, result is equal to that first element. I mean, first element star half height is equal to the first index element. First element, that is, we will get the first highest element into the first array, first index of that array. Minus k. K is the rep here, the energy which he naturally possesses. I mean, obviously the or naturally possess or height, natural height he can attain with his common general strength. So if result value is less than or equal to 0, and here you can, why I use this if case of result is less than or equal to 0, basically it can take, I mean, result value can maybe less than 0 also. I mean, a negative case may also occur, as the given height in the array, the given height may be less than the energy he possesses. I mean, suppose he can naturally jump the height of 10 units, but in the hurdle race the maximum height given was of 6, then we will get a value of resultant as minus 4. So in that case, then there is no need of getting of more energy, right? I mean, no need of drinking Red Bulls and wasting his money. There's no need of getting more energy. So there is, in that case, we can return directly 0, so that he doesn't need any Red Bull energy drinks. So else, if there is no need to value and the hurdles jumps are more higher than its respective ones, then he should consider the result. I mean, he should drink energy bulls, I mean Red Bull drinks. So he will return the value of the resultant. This is the main logic. These are the only two operations. The first operation is that of finding the highest height in that height array. And after that, we must check the condition that the result value is showing the output correct or not. So this is the problem I have seen. It's the basic problem only. It's just normal two operations. It's a very easy one. You should write only concept, I mean logic part only. So guys, I will post this link on the description. You can follow me on Instagram also. I will post the link in the description, so you can check it out. Okay guys, thank you. If you like the video, please do like, share and subscribe. Thank you guys, and keep watching for more info. Peace.